So I'm using 2 pounds of clay here, and that should give us enough to do what we want to do. We'll see. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to pull a cylinder and then I'll flare it out, because I don't want to, I want to see how that works. So we're going to pull straight up. Starting to flare out there, so I'll collar it in. Trying to feel how thick the clay is here, because from here up it seems pretty thin to me, so I'm going to go really easy here. You saw it, I was flaring out a little bit. At this point I'm going to take a measurement and see about where I am in this opening before I go ahead and do too much more. So here's what we're shooting for right here. We've got this set. And I'd say that we're right there. So what we don't want to do is open up any bigger than this, but we're going to open up right through here and squat it out a little bit. Once I pull this out here, I'm not going to be able to get into this bottom clay, and I'm going to do just a little trim here so that I won't have to do it later when I can't reach in there. Oops. Really hard to talk and do this at the same time. Remember this, when you're going to grab this up here, it's just a very quick stroke push down to the bat and don't let up until it's done. And then you can let up and then you've got your clay grabbed from there. Okay, so the next thing we want to do here is I'm going to take the sponge and I'm going to flare it out a little bit. And I think I like that. I will color this in. When I lift it up, I can kind of feel after a while, it's kind of thick, but a lot of that is in the bottom. I made the bottom extra thick because of the way the heat from the candle is going to heat that up, and I want that to kind of stay as much heat as we can get out of that candle. That's the objective here. Objective is to get as much energy from a candle as we possibly can. So what we'll be doing is using some of that energy to put moisture into the air, and we'll be using some of that energy to heat up the room a little bit. Not very much on the heating of the room, but it will have an effect on it. So I'm using the straight edge, and I'm just going to slowly push down on that inside wall. Make sure the lip stays right in there. So because I'm going to have to take this off the bat and trim it, I'm going to give it a little head start on drying. And that is because I want to trim the bottom before I can put on the handle and the spout. So I'm just going to give it a little head start here, heat it up. Gotta be careful on this lid because it'll suck that water right out of there pretty fast. Spend your time where it's real heavy down here at the bottom. You can start to see it drying the bat down there. Now I'm working my way to the top, and as soon as I see that rim, I'm gonna hit it a little bit, but I'm not gonna hit it too much. See, I'm still on the pot, now I'm on the rim. Now I'm back on the pot, and I want to get a little bit of this in here. Just have to be a little bit of fast movement, because it will dry out that clay right up there, and you won't like it. You can start to see maybe the steam coming off the piece. So it's getting rid of all of its water right now, kind of boiling it away. That's about as far as I'm going to go with this because I don't want it to get too hot. All I'm looking for is a little head start as I work on other pieces to be able to take it off of here when I go to lift it up. Still see it's quite wet down there on inside. That move with the wheel turning, you have to be careful with that, but I wanted to do that because I know it moves it off center. Obviously, it's now not on center, and you can't do anything with the piece anymore. But I need to remove this pot from this bat while it's still a little bit wet, so we can get it turned over, trim the bottom, and then we're going to put a handle and a spout on it. So that's where we're at. It's a little bit heavy to me, so I might do some little decorations. I could tell you it'll be heavy down here at the bottom. And we might just carve some of that clay off there to lighten it up, even though I think it, for the purpose, it might be better that it is a little bit on the heavy side, because it'll absorb some of that energy from the candle and hold it in for a longer period of time. So I'm going to use a zipping grip here, since it's so fast to get in piece. My jig centered here. I have about a half a pound of clay, and what I'm going to do is basically just thin it out a little bit here on my palm. Give it a little bit of forward motion. Now, I could have done a lot less clay than this, obviously. Look at how thick it is already. But it just seems that I have it and I'm ready to go. Point. I think what I'm going to do is trim this off, since I got quite a bit of clay here. I'm going to try to trim off where it would be not hitting. It's going to be at least on the clay. It's not going to go off. That's just one trim. We're going to have to do a couple more, I'm sure of it. So I'm going to leave this up here at the top, because remember, I'm going to throw that knob up there, and just working myself down here as I go. Watch how I can roll that little wave up there. Now, since we didn't center and do all that other stuff, you can see it's out of balance up here. So what I'm going to do is try to push all that up and then cut it off. Again, you can see it's out of balance, And now that I've pretty much pulled that up, we should be okay. So we'll just kind of finish flaring out this knob so you can grab it. See, when we start getting out of balance down here, this is about where we're going to cut it, right here. See, we're well in here, so that when it dries up a little bit, we'll be able to clean this off and make it snug it up to our base. So now it's just time for it to dry. Again, these lids aren't maybe as important as other pieces are at this particular time. Still going to dry it. I only have one of these jigs. I have 3 teapots to make. We'll just let it sit here. It doesn't want to release yet. I'm going to have to work on something else. Okay, so let's try this again then. Certainly don't need that much clay. I really don't want to open it up anymore. Oh, it's easy to make a big fat one, isn't it? I just gotta think about not opening it up. Powering it shut when I do. That's it. Now I'm just going to close up and help it out because I can feel it wants to, it just wants to twist. Me, it's like the clay almost talks to me, so it's really hard for me to talk and do what I need to do because the clay is telling me all the time how much pressure I can put on and what I should be doing. And I'm concentrating so much on that, I forget I'm supposed to be talking. Before I do anything else, I want to just... Yeah, I guess I could just take this off with the bat first. With the kidney tool. With something straight, smooth, that can scrape. Guiding it on there, I'm not doing anything but just letting it rest on there, trying to pick up any of that wet clay that's down there. The important thing with this particular tool thing about this particular tool is that it really needs to be kept clean and fresh so that it doesn't leave any marks on your clay. So I have a clean area over here where I keep it. A lot of people want to know why I use the flame so much. It's because I have to throw with really a wet clay because I have some health issues going on, especially in my fingers. I just don't want it to twist here, because when you're working up at that top area, the torque of the wheel just wants to twist the clay. That's what happened to me last time, so I don't want it to happen this time. I'm just trying to... There's really nothing down here. That clay gets pretty hot, but it does stiffen it up quite a bit. Just so I don't get burned, I guess I'll just use this stick here. So I just pushed out with the stick, so that's where the stick is right there. And then I'm just going to see what I can do here. I like it so far. Yeah, I'm just gonna. Get that hole to drain any of the water out. And let her dry up.